Hi, I'm Theodore Shapiro, and I scored Trumbo. In college, I was a music major, and I studied composition, and then I went on to the Juilliard School for a master's in composition. I think the first film that I did where I really felt like, okay, I feel like I'm getting the hang of this, I did a movie called Girl Fight. It was maybe the first opportunity that I'd had to write a film score where the music could really put a strong stamp on the movie. After I worked on Girl Fight, that got the attention of David Mamet. So I did a couple of movies with David Mamet, State and Main, and then Heist. I got involved with Trumbo because I had done a number of films with the director Jay Roach. We started working together first on Dinner for Schmucks, and then that led to Game Change and also The Campaign. And working with Jay is just one of the great privileges as a film composer. He's one of the nicest people that you can possibly meet and work with. He's a great collaborator to have. My first interaction with Trumbo was reading the script, which I thought was excellent. Right after they wrapped, or even maybe when they were getting towards the end of production, Jay sent me a collection of scenes that they had cut together. So I started to get a sense of what the material was going to look and feel like, and it definitely got the creative juices flowing. The value of the director-composer relationship being strong and based on history and trust is that you really get the opportunity to work not from the basis of replacing something that's cut in from another movie and making it kind of like that, but really starting from a foundation of just pure inspiration based on the material. One of the things that I was most intent on doing with the score to Trumbo was to avoid putting it too much in the box of a period film. I wanted the music to have some kind of modern sensibility because I wanted the material to feel immediate and not just like some distant relic of the past. What I wanted to do was to take elements of the period style, some of the language of jazz and the harmonic ideas, and use those as an ingredient in something that felt a little bit more modern and influenced by minimalism. So somehow make something that felt modern but built out of period elements. There was a scene in the beginning of the film where we are looking at Trumbo's accomplishments. We're seeing him at the typewriter, we're seeing the movie posters of things that he's written. And that's probably the most straight period cue in the movie. I wanted to try to use that cue to set up the period more directly and more literally. And then as the movie goes on and as we get into the story, allow it to move more clearly into something that feels modern and where the period elements are more abstract. With the orchestration of the film, I knew I wanted to have a brass ensemble that is not a literal big band ensemble, but something that evoked the idea of a big band sound. The prepared piano was an important voice in the score. Now, prepared piano is where you take just a regular piano and you stick things like screws and bolts and nuts and things into the strings. And when you do that, you create this odd, percussive, sort of weird instrument. It just gives the movie this off-kilter, percussive element that I think helped to pull it into a more modern style. The most challenging scene to score was also my favorite scene to score, the scene at the airport. It took a lot of fine-tuning to find the language that was supporting the movie and supporting the emotional content of the scene without pushing too hard on it. Orchestra for Trumbo was 41 players. It was 31 strings plus brass and piano and harp. And we recorded it in Los Angeles through the union. That was very, very important to me and really to everybody, given Dalton Trumbo's support for organized labor and, you know, just who he was. It was really critically important that we do this through the union and support our local musicians who are so incredible.